I feel like this is the most my reflection has ever been so clearly there, isn't it? Or am I imagining it's not paying enough attention before? Hey, whoever we got so far. I got some guesses as to who we have, but I'll let you introduce yourselves. This got moved. Maybe that's why. Oh, right. Because Gambit was horizontal. That's right, too. Hey, Billy. You did. Welcome. And hey, Mark. Marco G. Oh, hi, Mark. Okay. So we're going to draw a couple Rockabilly characters. Today. Oh, my God. I just noticed that was tangled, and then it fell the last right before I could pick up on it. There we go. Sorry. I hope that didn't freak anybody out. Okay. Alright, then let's get to it, shall we? I feel like the lighting's extra bright. It's so inconsistent, no matter what. I use the same settings all the time. I don't know. Bob? What about Bob? I have a pose kind of in mind, slightly inspired by an image, but I'm also taking a fair amount of liberties. Oh. In that case, well done, Billy. How are we doing? What are we up to tonight? Besides this. Editing still, I'm assuming, Mark? Hey, Dio. Chillin' is recommended. I let myself chill a bit before I went live here. I watched Emily the Criminal with Aubrey Plaza. And by that, I mean that she was in the movie. I didn't actually watch it with Aubrey Plaza. I mean, she would have been welcome, but I don't have her number. Sounds right. I get that. I've acted in a handful of student films at the school, actually. So I've had that experience. And I've done quite a bit of voice work, actually, as well. So I'm used to hearing the voice. Some accents, yeah. This is true. Yeah, that's the more like Bob and Doug McKenzie, like, take off, you hoser. Hey Parker. Fluent nonsense is actually a really good language worth learning. That's how I got through high school, actually. I mastered the art of saying the same thing 8 different times in a report without making it sound repetitive. Alright, I'm kind of cool with these poses. They'll do. I mean, there's still a rockabilly culture here as well. Rockabilly is actually pretty modern. It's like, it takes the 50s aesthetic, but it's a modern thing, though. I have kind of a thing for like vintagey motifs, so I just kind of dig rockabilly. Oh yeah. Because you wouldn't have a place to store it, or just because of the logistics of getting it there? Sometimes, especially on Sundays, not like every Sunday, but it'll usually be on a Sunday if you see it at all, you'll be driving around Vancouver or somewhere, and you'll actually suddenly notice like a shit ton of like old retro cars on the road, and they're usually on their way to some vintage car show or something, which would be very heavily rockabilly-esque. Thank you. veto. That's cool, Billy. You clearly know so much more about cars than I do, Mark. Just saying. I'm appreciating all you're saying, but I'm only understanding a portion of it. I like the idea of going to a drive-in in an old retro-y car. I was hoping to get to the drive-in this summer, but it never did happen. I only went for the first time ever, I guess almost 5 years ago now. So I guess it was longer ago than I realized, but yeah. That's cool. First drive-in movie I went to was The Meg. As a movie nerd, I always wanted to go to the drive-in because I thought just the idea of it's cool and it's kind of part of like movie history, but I was also because of a movie geek, I was always worried about like the quality of the sound and all that kind of stuff. But then The Meg seemed like the perfect one to finally go to because it was a monster movie, and then ended up going a bunch of other times as well. Yeah. I definitely want to give this character tattoos, but I'm kind of tempted to save that for digital. Baja the van? Okay, gotcha. Do you know who Ed Big Daddy Roth is? Thought you might. I've been a fan of Ed Roth since before I had any idea what any of that shit was. I didn't even know what a hot rod was. I think my dad pointed it out to me in like a store or something, or it might have even been an antique store for that matter. And just thought the design of them was so cool. When I was in art school for a while, I had Ratfink as my desktop background. I remember one of the teachers being kind of taken with it because it was so so before my time. Do a very specific type of shirt for this guy, but oh, nice. I watched a documentary about years ago that was kind of neat. Like they didn't have a lot of footage to work with, so they kind of did like motion graphics using a bunch of photos and a bunch of his art. And it was a really neat documentary. Like I feel like it probably was a turnoff to a lot of people that it was so reliant on motion graphics, but because he's an artist and so much of the motion graphics used his art, I thought it was super cool because you were learning about him and just like looking at his art the whole time. Just kind of part of the fun of watching any documentary about an artist is looking at their stuff. So yeah, there's gonna be more going on with the shirt, but I'm gonna save that for when I ink it. Forget what the hell it was called, unfortunately, though. Which make it a lot easier to look it up, but I don't know how many docs there have been made about them, so it might be pretty easy. Hey, Brad. How are we doing? I'm drawing a couple of Rockabilly characters. How's your night going? Is Doomsday tomorrow? Or is that like Wednesday next week? Okay. Gotcha, gotcha. Maybe we are sometimes, Willie. You rock too. It's possible. I think I'm gonna do Phoenix next, but I don't know exactly when I'll draw it. Probably won't be till the new year. I think I'm gonna do something else non-X-Men related next week, and then the week after that I might do. I have a fan art, kind of Christmassy fan art planned, and then I'll probably take a little bit of time. I'm gonna be away for the second week of our break, so the first week I'll do like one stream, but probably won't be able to do the second one, but I am excited to do Phoenix though, so probably won't wait too long before I get to her. Rockabilly Billy, I like that. Probably not, Parker. I'll post some art while I'm away. But all right, let's ink. Let us ink. Did I tell you guys I finally booked my tattoo? January 14th. I shall be inked. I don't know much about Legion, actually. I've heard good things about the show. And there's a Legion cover that I always show as an example in my comics class, because they do this really cool kind of visual representation of hearing voices. But I haven't read the comic. I don't know a lot about him. What makes you ask, Mark? Just because we were talking X-Men, or? It will not be a Combat Fairies tattoo, no. It is the same thing, Billy. The show is based on the comic, yeah. But I assume Mark knew that. Have you watched the show, Mark? Have you watched the show, Billy, actually, for that matter? Since you brought... Like I said, I've heard good things. It is, actually, yeah. But it's on my list to get to because of that. But I have, Brad. I drew the entire Fellowship a while back now, actually. Or, well, I mean, it would have been at least a year ago. I actually, I was selling prints of it at Fan Expo last year, so I guess it would have been probably in my 2021 batch. Because it was this year I was selling it, I guess. So, yeah. So, last year, I guess I drew it. If you dig back on my Insta, you'll find it on there somewhere. Legion started actually before Disney bought Fox originally, but it was on FX, I think, originally. Okay, so maybe I shouldn't make it a drawing show, in other words, Billy. Yeah, he's Professor X's son. Do you mean of any kind, Mark, or just cable? Because I also have not paid for cable in quite some time. Or really ever, thinking about it. Streaming, yes. Cable, no. Hey Chantel, been a while, how are you? Oh, sorry to hear that. Just the flu, or are we talking COVID? How's work been with the Christmas rush and all that? Yeah, that makes sense. And I have a pretty strong feeling that it's probably cold as fuck out there, am I right? It's cold as fuck here. And we're like maybe the warmest province in Canada, typically. Okay. Fun times. Are you outside because you're taking like loads to people's cars, or because you were doing online fulfillment, weren't you? Okay. So you off sick right now? Gotcha, gotcha. Gotcha. Yeah. I was a little slow getting to my Christmas shopping this year. Otherwise, I would have ordered most of it. I did order something, but I'm not sure if it's going to arrive on time for my parents. So it could end up being birthday gifts if it don't arrive on time. I did my annual Christmas Metrotown Mall tour on Wednesday, and I've had enough of people, I think, until next year at this point. Cable's being extra annoying tonight for some reason. I buy for my parents, and that's pretty much it. And then, some years other people, but it depends on what's happening and stuff. But my parents are the only constant. We are Venom. Isn't there another? Wasn't the bad guy in the Ghost Rider movie also named Legion? So, is there two Legions in the Marvel comic universe? That's kind of how I usually play it with my parents. I've been making a gift for them since I was a kid, but I'll usually buy something to go with it as well. I'm also an only child, and my parents have a tendency to spoil me, so I like to get some added stuff. So I've ordered a gift for them, but I've also ordered something to be printed on something. And I won't elaborate in case my mom is watching right now, because she does occasionally do that. I don't know how often she has the sound on, though. I'm confident that one will be here on time. Historically, that goes pretty quick, but the other stuff, that's in Yoda's hands now. Thank you. She'd have to sign in for that though, Mark. And I think she does have an account technically. Because she usually gives me her free Amazon subscription. But I don't know if she ever actually has it logged in or not. But I assure you, Mark, I was a perfect angel. The biggest drawing I've ever done, in terms of like scope and detail or like actual physical size? My guess would be either way, it would probably be one of the two-page spreads from my comic. Because I draw those comic pages on 11x17 paper. And so a two-page spread is two of those taped together. And I've done a few pretty complicated ones. I did one that I drew on the stream, or inked on the stream, and it took me about 7 hours to ink it. I think it still to date is the longest stream I've done. Unless you count my Tim Burton Batman stream from, I think it was last year. And because I split that into two, I ran out of time during the stream, so I finished it the next morning. And if you stuck those two together, that might have surpassed the 7 hour mark. Lord of the Rings one's pretty big. What Nazi background are you talking about, Chantel? Is that something you did? I don't think I've ever drawn anything Nazi related. The Lord of the Rings one, I mean, that was a full size, but probably not as big as the, because that was 11x17. Actually, you know what? Now that you say that, Mark, okay, the biggest one I ever did is I painted the garage door on my parents' garage. I painted it to look like the inside of the garage, actually, with the car parked in and everything. Oh, okay, okay. That makes sense. Trying to tell. I think when I painted that garage door, it was a bit eye-opening for our neighbors. Because we had this one set of neighbors that... I might be totally wrong on this, but I always felt like they had this impression that I was some sort of delinquent. Just because I kind of kept to myself and stuff and wasn't super chatty at any point. And then I remember one of them, she came home from like a... I think I had just finished art school, I think. So I would have been like 19, 20. And she just came home from like a run and stopped to see me painting it and was just kind of stunned for a second and went, cool. And then I was like, thanks. And then I kind of felt like the vibe was totally different after that. But I might have been imagining it. That was the title of it, Mark. It was Sound of Music with Nazis. Or sorry, no, Sound of Music had not. I mean, Macbeth with Nazis. Had a very avant-garde theater instructor at that school. Really wanted to shake things up. Wow. And please tell me I'm right, Chantel, and that's actually what they called it. Saskatoon High School presents production of Macbeth with Nazis. See what you did there, Parker. Well done. Well done. Okay. Did they give you a helmet at least? My elementary school did Grease, speaking of Rockabilly. I wasn't like leading any team or anything like that, but I was on the art. Like they got the whole school involved. So I was on the art crew and I drew one of the posters to promote it. Helped to like draw giant brick walls on giant rollout paper that they put up, so it wasn't too elaborate of a set. Pretty low production. Another good one, Parker. I feel like it might have been more fun to actually spill paint on the floor if you gave that possibility an option. Like, if you tried it out. You might have really been selling yourself short there, Chantel. You could have carried the whole production. Okay, that was actually an accidental pun, but I'm going to take it. I'm going to roll with that. Centane, if you're lurking, join us for the Ink Ink song. Ink, ink, ink. Ink, ink, ink. This is the Ink Ink song. So you totally could have gone full carry on it if you wanted to. Was the paint red? Actually, wait, what were you even doing with a bucket of paint up there? Shouldn't it already have been painted by the time they were... Or were you burying the lead? Were you actually debating dumping it on people the entire time? Oh, you mean while you were up there painting it, you mean? I thought you meant during the production. So were you painting right on the wall? Or were you painting on like a giant piece of paper or something that they put up? I wonder if you could get away with a play like that now, because I assume I'm going to take a shot in the dark, give your school and your drama teacher the benefit of the doubt, that the play was intended to be anti-Nazi. But if you still were painting the gym to be covered with swastikas and stuff, I feel like no matter what the intent, if you did it today, people would say something about it. Sometimes they don't really look at the intent so much as they look at the pieces and they don't look at the message, you know? Thematically, I get how the plot could be blended, but I just mean like it can be sticky, you know. But that's the thing, though. That's what I mean. Like, I assume they weren't portrayed that way. But I feel like a parent walks into the gym, they see a swastika on the wall. They're probably freaking out before they're answering questions if it comes out today. That's just the vibe I get. Suddenly it's on Twitter. And then all of a sudden the drama teacher is being interviewed on the local news to explain the point of the play, you know? That's cool. I don't know if I ever went to any of the plays that my high school put on. Other than, like, when we were in elementary school, we went to a play at the high school as, like, a field trip one time. I think it was The Music Man? Actually, we might have done it twice. I think we saw Showboat there as well. But then once I was actually at the high school, I don't think I ever went to any of the plays. Bang, bang, you're dead. To be honest, I'm kind of kind of liking that they're doing kind of crime ones and stuff, though. It's kind of cool. I feel like I know the name Bang Bang You're Dead, though. Is that a known play, or is that another story? Or am I getting mixed up with something else? Oh, fuck. That's pushing it. SNL used to do recurring bits sometimes where there'd be like a high school production of something and it's like intended to be really deep but it's like super lame with terrible acting. Wow. I mean, not to say that I am opposed to that story, it seems so risque for a high school to go that direction. Unless they did get Guy Ritchie, that's kind of cool. I could support that idea, Mark. I guess if it's a known play that already has some recognition, it's not that risque, because you can point teachers or concerned parents to that immediately. Okay. I'm kind of surprised, actually, in a way, but it's probably just because I was too young and naive at the time. I feel like I wasn't as aware of any shootings at that time. probably being in Canada is part of that as well. Like, I'm very aware of them now, you know. But that they would be enough to prompt a play based on it. But again, like you said, they weren't based on a real shooting, so. They ever make a movie of it? Yeah, it's true too. Yeah, I would assume so. But yeah, social media would be a big part of why it might have gone over my head, as well as probably my age being a little bit more blind to stuff in general. That's unfortunate. Like all decongestants. I feel like I've been doing that more lately, like stumbling over my words and having to like slow down to enunciate better. I don't know what that's about. Atheist is the name of a decongestant? Oh, gotcha. Okay, that makes more sense. I was like, that's. I'm not opposed to it. I'm just shocked. And then if there was atheist decongestants, I'd be wondering, like, is there Catholic and Protestant ones and stuff too? Like, do I specifically need to get the atheist ones just for being atheist? I didn't think they discriminated like that. By the way, Mark, this is the same music you gave me the other night on Tuesday. I can run this one for a while. It's like 11 hours long, so I figure I'll pick up where it left off next time, and then again. It'll be a while before we hear the same part twice. So thank you for that. You said that you did research to make sure this one would be okay. What was the extent of your research? How'd you go about that? Okay. So like the artist or the track or like did you find it first or did you Google like safe royalty-free music and then that was recommended by someone somewhere? Okay, so is the channel supposed to be entirely royalty free? So if I find something else in that channel, should I be safe? Okay. Well, then I'll explore the site even more. Thank you again. Okay, cool. Serena still streams pretty often, right, Mark? I haven't caught one of her streams in quite a while. But I often miss out on streams. Usually I'll notice the notification on my phone when they're just about finished or already finished. I'm most actively noticing my phone notifications when I'm not in a position to actually do anything about it. I don't know, Brad, what happened? I see what you did there. You realize what you've done, though, Red? You have now brought a barrage of dad jokes upon us. I guarantee you there's at least one or two people Googling or thinking about other dad jokes right now. I guarantee it. If they weren't before, they are now that I said that. Chuck Norris jokes. There is no evolution, only a list of creatures Chuck Norris has allowed to live. What, Chantel? Nice, nice. Chuck Norris goes for a job interview, they ask him for a recommendation. Don't know what's in your pocket, Billy. So it is the precious then. Okay, it's not a Chuck Norris joke, but this guy's at a funeral, and he asks the widow if he can get up and say something, and she says sure. So he stands up and he says plethora, and then she says thanks, that means a lot. Chuck Norris's mom has a tattoo that says son. I don't know, what do you call a security guard working outside a Samsung shop? Nice. You guys hear about the fire at the shoe factory? 1,000 souls were lost. Guys, want to hear a pizza joke? Nah, never mind. It's too cheesy. Sleepy waits. Made a tension point. No! In 30 seconds. Chuck Norris is so cool, his 5 o'clock shadow arrives fashionably late. Or you could say the opposite, Chuck Norris is so manly, I guess. His 5 o'clock shadow arrives at 3. Chuck Norris's business card just says, "Call me." Chuck Norris is so tough that under his beard there is no chin, only another fist. Those are both good too. What is a pizza maker's favorite song? What? Yikes. That's a dad joke and a half, that one. Uh, Wow. Oh yeah, how'd that go? Or is this part of another joke? Why did Jabba win the pizza contest? I don't know why. By the way, you can keep giving them. It doesn't have to be your last one. Nice. How warm is the inside of a tauntaun? Lukewarm. Ha! Stupid wire today. What is up with it? I don't know if it's worse today or if I'm just less patient for it today. What kind of bee makes milk? Yes. Bite and Melons Get Married. Because they can't elope. How do celebrities stay cool? They have many fans. Thanks, Brad. Oh, you're having it? Okay, have a good night. Have a good one. Oh, but yeah, I am with Mark. We gotta hear another joke from you. This tune took a turn. Wasn't expecting that. When the boogeyman goes to sleep every night, he checks his closet for Chuck Norris. Okay. It's true, it is a fact.
Three, two, one, zero, zero,
Who's there? Tank who? Well played, sir. I will color it eventually, QDP-17. Not tonight, though. Also, welcome to the stream. Good night, Brad. Are you a Rockabilly fan, QDP? Your friend is a fan? gonna be more with this shirt soon. We're almost done, but we're not quite as done as it appears. Thank you for the follow, QDP. What brings you to our stream, QDP? Just looking for art? Are you an artist yourself? Or are you somebody that I know and I'm just not recognizing the name? You're an artist, or you're someone I know, or both. Thank you. They were unfair questions, were they? I get self-conscious about this because people I know pop in so often, but I don't always remember which screen name is whose. And I don't like talking to somebody that I know as if I don't know them, because I feel rude. Okay. So, we're almost done, but not white. All right. do one more. Okay. Now we're done. Now we can sign this bad boy. There we go. we go. It is signed. Thank you, Chantel. We'll raid somebody before we pull the plug here. Thank you, Merc. Thank you, Parker. So as usual, stick around just to give them a little bump. Don't need a thank you, Billy. Don't need to stick around too long if you're not feeling it. I'm probably going to crash pretty soon myself. But let's... I didn't think of them as anime glasses, but sure, I'll take that too, Merc. Thanks. But let's find somebody. Let's see who's live. See you, Dio. Thank you. Let's see. Meg's streaming, but we raided her last time, so let's do maybe Jubiart. Sure, let's do that. Oh, oops. What happened there? There we go. Rating in 2-1.